Dios.
Two exploits that you've heard in the news or the three variations of them, but also to walk you through some concepts in computer architecture that they exploit, have some time to think about where we're going as an industry, and then we'll take questions toward the end. Now, I did a preview version of this talk a few days ago at Stanford over in California, and it took 2.5 hours to get through the slides. Now, the good news is that I have only 45 minutes here, and I've added 5 slides since. So, what you're gonna see is, at various points, is skipping over slides that contain explanation for diagrams that I've showed you, right? The idea is that if you want the long-form version, in particular, if English is not your first language, or this is the first time you've seen a concept, you can go and read the long-form explanation. And you can download the slides right now. Follow at John Masters, that Twitter handle right there. You'll see a link. And we're going to do a load stress test on people.redhat.com. We're going to see how well it stands, everyone trying to download these slides at the same time. So feel free to pull them down and look ahead and speculate about what's coming in the future. Okay, so. And I'd like to just ask a couple of quick questions. So hands up if you have studied or looked at computer architecture in the past. Okay, good. So the first half of this is going to go really quickly. Hands up if you have read the paper or papers relating to the exploits I'm talking about today. Just a good show of hands. Hands up if you think you understood it. Okay, it's still a good set of hands there. Hands up if this is all fairly new to you and you would really benefit from me walking through it in some level of detail. Okay, good. So about 50% of you think you know everything I'm going to say, and 50% of you are not sure. So that's a good mix. So today's class is going to cover, I did take this from the definition of Stanford, so it was a lecture. Today I'm going to cover the difference between architecture and microarchitecture. Some variations of microarchitecture, so what that means in the real world. I'm going to talk about caches and virtual memory and branch predictors, which are some of the pieces that you need to exploit to make these kinds of attacks successful. I'll talk about side channel analysis, which is an interesting topic in itself. And then I'll look at the actual vulnerabilities that you've seen, the mitigations we have for them, and then finally some related research into hardware exploits that maybe you have not seen before. So, architecture versus microarchitecture. For those of you who were at the RISC-V sessions, you probably saw similar content already. But when we talk about computers, we have this concept.